Hello students, very good morning. So in previous class you studied about in detail aspects of bacteria, isn't it? So that is about structure of bacteria, ultrastructure, so then the reproduction in bacteria and also the economic importance of bacteria. Okay, so thereby it completes about the organisms bacteria. Okay, so in this video I'm going to explain about the next members of the kingdom Monera. Okay, so that is about blue-green algae or cyanobacteria. It is about blue-green algae or cyanobacteria. Okay, see, these blue-green algae or cyanobacteria, they belongs to the class Myxophysiae or Cyanophysiae. Okay, so where the kingdom Monera, you know that is divided into Schizophyta as well as Cyanophyta, the division Cyanophyta. Okay, and protophyta, isn't it? There are three divisions were observed in the kingdom Monera. So one is Schizophyta, Cyanophyta and protophyta. So among this, Schizophyta that was completed, that includes Archaebacteria as well as the Eubacteria. So then under the division Cyanophyta, so the only one class, that is Cyanophysiae or Myxophysiae. Okay, so that includes Cyanobacteria or blue-green algae. See, the name itself indicates blue-green algae. The algae means these organisms, they exhibit both the blue as well as green color. Their plant body, it is bluish green in nature. That's why they were named as blue-green algae. They were named as cyanobacteria, okay, because of the presence of a characteristic pigment, that is what is called as phycocyanin. A blue-colored characteristic pigment is present in them, that is called as phycocyanin. Because of the presence of this pigment, phycocyanin. See, this is a blue colored pigment. This is a blue colored pigment. Because of the presence of this pigment, phycocyanin, they were popularly named as cyanobacteria. Okay. So then where these organisms were present? Occurrence of these organisms. See, cyanobacteria, they usually occurs in water. Okay, whether it is a fresh water or sometimes it may be some of the forms, they are also found in marine water. Okay. So fresh water means they are found in the ponds, pools, lakes, ditches, okay, or in logged water. So or on the surface of the rocks or even on the surface, any moist surface. Okay. So they were found mainly in water. They occurs mainly in water. Okay. Especially they may be freshwater forms. Freshwater means the sweet water of the ponds, pools, lakes or ditches. Okay. Freshwater forms. Or they may be marine forms. Some of the forms are marine. Okay. So they may even found on the surfaces, the moist surfaces like rocks. Pachi in the Kelibodi. So wherever the water that always flows on the surfaces of the stones or rocks, so there there will be development of these organisms, cyanobacterian organisms. So these organisms, especially the blue-green algae, they are photosynthetic in nature. When compared with the bacteria, so where not all bacteria are photosynthetic, but these organisms are all of them, the members of the Cyanophysiae, they are photosynthetic in nature. They have a characteristic blue colored pigment, I said that phycocyanin, along with that chlorophyll A, along with the other pigments like chlorophyll A, then beta carotene, okay, and phycoerythrin. This is red colored pigment and phycoerythrin. Okay, so these are the pigments. The major one is phycocyanin, this is a major one. This is a blue colored pigment. Because of the presence of blue and greenish color, that's why they are commonly known as blue-green algae. So the pigments like chlorophyll A, beta-carotene, phycoerythrin, this is a red colored pigment. Phycoerythrin is a red colored one. Phycoerythrin and phycocyanin. Okay. So these are the pigments which are found in these organisms, in cyanobacteria. So they may be freshwater forms or they may be marine water forms, and also they can grow on the moist surfaces like rocks or any wooden logs. Okay. So among this, a member of cyanobacteria called as Trichodermium erythraceum. a member of cyanobacteria called as Trichoderma erythraceum. So this gives a characteristic red color. It imparts a characteristic red color to the sea. That's why the sea is popularly known as Red Sea. Okay, you might have heard about Red Sea. So where it looks red in color, appears red in color, that is mainly because of the extensive growth of this cyanobacteria, Trichoderma erythraceum. So it looks red mainly because the cells will contain phycoerythrin, more quantity of phycoerythrin. That's why they look red in color and they imparts red color for the sea. Okay, so where that pigment, what is called as phycoerythrin, this is a red colored pigment. Okay, so there are two major pigments can be seen. One is phycocyanin and phycoerythrin along with chlorophyll A, then along with beta carotene. Okay, so I said about the occurrence of these organisms. Okay, then about the thallus organization, means the structure of the body, how these organisms will occur. Okay, so that is what is called as thallus. I said, what is a thallus? A thallus is an undifferentiated plant body, means without differentiation of root, stem and leaf. Okay, so what is the organization of thallus here? See, the members of these organisms, the cyanobacteria, they may be unicellular. Some of them, they may be unicellular. Okay, so some of them, they may be colonial. Some of them, they may be colonial. So what is colonial here? Colonial means group. These organisms are the cells which occurs in a group and surrounded by a common mucilaginous membrane, and where the cells which occurs in a group are a colony. They occurs in a group or a colony like this. And this colony gets surrounded by a common membrane, a mucilaginous sheath. Okay, a common slimy mucilaginous sheath that can be seen around the colony. So such forms are said to be colonial. For example, like microcystis. Microcystis. Okay, so this is one of the member of cyanobacteria that commonly found in ponds, pools or ditches. Okay. Similarly, unicellular forms, for example, like Crewcoccus. Okay, so this is an unicellular form. Okay. Or they may be colonial, or even they may be filamentous in nature. They may be filamentous. Filamentous means the cells are arranged in the form of a chain. Okay. So chain form will arrange agidre. The cells are arranged one above the other in the form of a chain. Okay. Surrounded by a mucilaginous sheath. So one of the most characteristic feature of the members of cyanobacteria, where all cells get surrounded by mucilaginous sheath. All cells get surrounded by mucilaginous sheath. Mucilaginous sheath means a slimy sheath that surrounds the cell, that protects the cell from desiccation or dehydration. Okay. And also, as they are found in water, it prevents the cells from the effect of water, mainly from dryness or desiccation. Okay. So where the cells are surrounded by the mucilaginous sheath. So some of them, they may be unicellular, means they occur singly as single cells. Some of them, they may be colonial, means they occur in group and surrounded by a common mucilaginous membrane, and some may be filamentous. So filamentous form, where the cells arrange in the form of a chain and they are arranged one above the other and they are surrounded by a common mucilaginous membrane. Okay. So usually the filaments are unbranched. Usually they are unbranched, but some of the forms, they show pseudo branching, means false branching. Some forms, they show false branching, but not actually the true branches. But usually the filaments are unbranched in nature. Okay. So then let us look into the cell structure, how the cell will be. Structure of the cell or cell structure. Cell structure. Okay. See, we have studied about the cell structure of bacteria, isn't it? So unlike bacteria, the cyanobacterial cells, they are slightly larger. Okay, and they are more complex when compared to the bacterial cells. Okay. So here also, the cell is usually surrounded by a cell wall. A definite cell wall can be seen. Okay. The cells are surrounded by a definite cell wall. And in turn, the cell wall is surrounded by a mucilaginous sheath. I said that mucilaginous sheath is a characteristic feature here, because it protects the cells from desiccation or dehydration and also by the effect of water. Okay, so where the cells get surrounded by a mucilaginous, means a slimy sheath that surrounds the cell, a mucilaginous sheath. So then beneath the cell wall there will be a cell membrane. Beneath the cell wall there will be a cell membrane. See here, the cell wall in these members is made up of cellulose. The cell wall in these members, it is made up of cellulose. Okay, but few forms they also show peptidoglycan, that is like in bacteria. But whereas in bacteria the cell wall component is peptidoglycan, but here the cell wall is mainly made up of cellulose like the plants. Okay, but some of the forms they also show peptidoglycan as a cell wall material. So cell wall is surrounded by mucilaginous sheath. Next to cell wall internally there will be a plasma membrane. So then they encloses a protoplasm. Protoplasm is nothing but the entire content of the cell. They encloses a protoplasm. See, mainly the protoplasm in these members, it is mainly differentiated into the outer region. The outer region, that is what we call as chromoplasm. The outer region of the protoplasm is known as chromoplasm. Chroma means color. You write the diagram first. Okay, the outer region of the protoplasm is what is known as chromoplasm. And whereas the inner region is colorless, or it is hyaline, and that consists of a double-stranded DNA. In the outer region, which is colored here, okay, colored, it is mainly because of the presence of photosynthetic pigments, isn't it? See, this entire thing found inside the cell is what is known as the protoplasm. Okay, the entire thing that is found inside the cell, that is regarded as a protoplasm, that includes all the cytoplasm, the DNA and the other elements, okay, all those things which are found inside the cell, and all together that is what is called as a protoplasm. Here the protoplasm of the cell, that mainly differentiates into the outer region of the protoplasm, is what is called as the chromoplasm. The outer region is known as chromoplasm. The outer region is called as chromoplasm, and an inner central region, the hyaline region, you can make out in the diagram, the inner region is what is known as centroplasm. The outer chromoplasm and the inner region is known as centroplasm. See, the outer chromoplasm is nothing but chroma means color. Okay, this region of protoplasm, which is colored in nature, that is mainly because of the presence of photosynthetic pigments. Okay, the photosynthetic pigments like chlorophyll and phycocyanin, phycoerythrin, beta carotene, all those pigments which are restricted to the outer surface or peripheral region of the protoplasm. Okay, protoplasm alli outer side alli athwa peripheral region alli photosynthetic pigments irutte. That's why this outer region of the protoplasm, which looks colored in nature, that is known as chromoplasm. Okay, and the central region is what is, which is hyaline or transparent in nature, it means it is colorless, hyaline or transparent, that is known as centroplasm. Okay, so this chromoplasm, that mainly consists of photosynthetic pigments which are found on lamella. There are no chloroplast structures, or there are no membrane bounded structures were present here, because these members are also prokaryotes in nature. Okay, so where here the outer surface, the consists of the pigments in the lamellae. Lamellae means thin membranous structures. They are thin membranous or sheath like structures on which the photosynthetic pigments are located. Idr melgade en irutte photosynthetic pigments locate agirutte. They are thin membranous or sheath like structures on which the photosynthetic pigments were located, and that is what is called as lamellae or thylakoid. You might have heard thylakoid in chloroplast. You just remember where the bundle like structures are, plate like structures which are arranged one above the other. Okay, they are what is called as thylakoid. Similarly here also there are sheath like or membranous structures which are what is called as lamellae, on which the photosynthetic pigments were distributed, like mainly phycoerythrin, cyanin, chlorophyll A and other photosynthetic pigments, isn't it? So that's why the outer peripheral region is what is called as chromoplasm. Chroma means color, plasma means the protoplasm. Okay, so whereas the central region is what is known as centroplasm. So this is hyaline in nature, means it is transparent because it doesn't consist of pigments here. There are no pigments were associated or found in the central region. So mainly this region that consists of reserve food material in the form of starch granules or oil, that is mainly known as cyanophycian starch. Remember this thing, the reserve food material in the members of cyanobacteria is what is called as cyanophycian starch. It is cyanophycian starch. This is the reserve food material, and that is distributed throughout the protoplasm. Okay, and the central region, the centroplasm, that consists of the DNA, a naked DNA, that is what is known as nucleoid. It consists of DNA. Here it is naked, then that is what is called as nucleoid in nature. Okay, and also this cells of these members that consists of vacuoles. They are what is called as pseudo vacuoles. Pseudo vacuoles called as pseudo vacuole. Means what is a vacuole here? A vacuole is a membranous structure, a pouch like or a sac like structure that usually stores either the reserve food material, or sometimes it may store air, or sometimes it may store other molecules like lipids or oil or pigments sometimes. Okay, see, a vacuole is a membranous sac like or a pouch like structure in which the reserve food material or the other elements which were stored, sometimes air is also stored. See here, in these organisms, as they are prokaryotes, here the vacuoles are regarded as pseudo vacuoles because they are not definitely bounded by a membrane. Okay, the membrane of the vacuole is known as tonoplast. Tonoplast and the perithivi, vacuole membrane. But here they are not definitely or exactly like the true vacuoles of eukaryotes. Here they are referred as pseudo vacuoles, and these pseudo vacuoles, they enclose air or gas. They are filled with the air or gas, so that helps in buoyancy. That helps in buoyancy. Buoyancy means floating. Okay, as they are the forms which are found in water, so where the cells are filaments, they float on the surface of water. Okay, so to float, they store air in their pseudo vacuoles. Okay, so that floating purpose, the mechanism is what is called as buoyancy, where the cells will float, or cells or the filaments or the colony, they get floats on the surface of water. That is known as buoyancy. That is mainly possible because of the presence of air-filled pseudo vacuoles. Okay, and besides that, these cells are also prokaryotes. They do not have any membrane-bounded cell organelles like mitochondria, Golgi bodies, or endoplasmic reticulum, whatever it may be. There are no membrane-bounded cell organelles are found here. And also, they consist of ribosomes of about 70 S type. I said what are 70 S types of ribosomes in the previous class. Okay, ribosomes are of 70 S type. Okay, and this is about the cell structure of cyanobacteria, where the cell is externally surrounded by a mucilaginous sheath. This is common character, and beneath that there will be a cell wall made up of cellulose usually. Then next to cell wall there will be a plasma membrane made up of lipids and proteins. To that there will be next protoplasm. Here protoplasm is mainly differentiated into outer chromoplasm or the peripheral chromoplasm, that is mainly colored because of the presence of pigments. In photosynthetic lamella, I said that there are thin membranous sheath-like structures which are distributed in the chromoplasm, and that consists of color. And the central region is what is known as centroplasm, and that centroplasm is usually colorless or hyaline or transparent. Okay, because pigments are not present here. And that consists of a centrally situated DNA, that is the nucleoid, naked DNA material. Okay, so besides that, they store reserve food material in the form of cyanophycian starch. And also they have vacuoles, pseudo vacuoles, which are filled with the air that helps in buoyancy. Okay, so this is about the cell structure. Okay, so then the next concept about the cyanobacteria is the reproduction of cyanobacteria. The next concept is about reproduction. Reproduction in cyanobacteria. See, as these are the members of Monera, there is no sexual reproduction. There is no sexual reproduction. These members, they reproduce only by means of asexual method. Asexual method of reproduction or vegetative method of reproduction. Asexual method and vegetative method of reproduction is seen. There is no sexual reproduction is here. Okay. See, the members which reproduce mainly by, in unicellular forms, mainly by means of fission. So just like in bacteria, so here also the unicellular forms, they reproduce by means of fission. Fission means division of cell. Okay, the cell goes on dividing and produces thousands of daughter cells. Okay, so mainly they divides by means of fission. And whereas in case of the filamentous forms, they reproduce by means of fragmentation, means the breaking of the filament. The filament that breaks, and each fragment that can give rise to the new filament. Okay, suppose if it is a filamentous form, either filamentous form is there, ಅವಾಗ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ನಾನು ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಚೈನ್ ವೆಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಬನ್ ಎಬೋದಿ ಅದರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಚೈನ್ ಸೊ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಮೇ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟಲಿ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಎ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಎನಿ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಫಿಶಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಅದರ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪಾಸಸ್ ಅಕ್ರಾಸ್ ದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಸಮಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಮೇ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟಲಿ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ಫುಲಿ ದ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ರಿಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ವೇ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟಲ್ ಬ್ರೇಕೇಜ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಬ್ರೇಕೇಜ್ ಈಚ್ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗ್ರೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ವೇರ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿವೈಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಮನ್ ಒನ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಲೋನಿಯಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದ ಕಲೋನಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇನ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸಿಸ್ಟಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಕಲೋನಿಯಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದ ಕಾಲೋನಿ ದಟ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜನರೇಟ್ ಎ ನ್ಯೂ ಕಾಲೋನಿ ದರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕಾಮನ್ ಒನ್ ಬಿಸೈಡ್ ದಟ್ ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ದ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಏಕೈನೀಟ್ಸ್ The reproduction also takes place by the structures what is called as akinetes. See here, the akinetes are nothing but they are the thick-walled, resistant or resting structures. Akinetes are thick-walled, resistant or resting structures which are usually found in the filamentous form. Usually they are found in the filamentous form. I will draw a filament now. Okay. And they are larger than the normal cells found. They're larger than the normal cells found in the filament. Andre filamental ira ella cell kinta akinetes enagirutte doddadagirutte. They're larger than the normal cells found in the filament. And also these members, especially some of the filamentous form, they show the structures what is called as heterocyst. I will tell the real functions of the heterocyst. Okay. So this is a filament of cyanobacteria. So these are the normal vegetative cells. Okay, you think this one has a heterocyst like this. The heterocyst will be like this. This is a heterocyst. Okay. So where and this one is akinete. I said akinetes are the larger cells other than the vegetative cell. Vegetative cell kind of bit too. ಏಕೈನೀಟ್ಸ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ದೊಡ್ಡದಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ಏಕೈನೀಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಥಿಕ್ ವಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆರಿ ಥಿಕ್ ವಾಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇರ್ ಸೈಜ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಏಕೈನೀಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ವೆರಿ ಥಿಕ್ ವಾಲ್ ದ ಸೈಜ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಅಬಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ಫುಡ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ದೇ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ವೆರಿ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಸರ್ವ್ ಫುಡ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಅನ್ಫೇವರಬಲ್ ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ದ ಡ್ರೈಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವಾಟರ್ ಬಾಡಿ Okay, in such conditions, though the other cells in the filament, they die. It means the other cells which are found in the filament, if they dies, akinetes will survive. Because they store very large amount of reserve food material and they are surrounded by a very thick wall. It is protecting the cell by means of desiccation or dehydration. Though there is a scarcity of water in the water body, where the akinetes, they can survive. Because they are surrounded by a very thick wall. Okay. These are other cells that are what is known as vegetative cells, where the cells will, if the cells will die in unfavorable condition, during that stage also akinetes can survive. So once the onset of favorable condition, once favorable condition mathe reoccur aadmele, so where the akinete cell, so where the divide and the thick wall that breaks and that can give rise to new filament. Okay, the where the akinete that can divide and that will produce the new filament. Okay, so that is about the akinetes. So this is also one of the mode of reproduction in cyanobacteria by means of akinetes. Okay. And the other structures which are found in the filament, not in all cyanobacteria, in some of the cyanobacteria, so they were what we call as heterocysts. See, these are very important structures and it can be asked for 1 mark in examination, what are heterocysts? See here, heterocysts is nothing but they are the nitrogen fixing structures. They are the nitrogen fixing structures. Nitrogen heterocysts are the nitrogen fixing structures which are found in the filaments of few cyanobacteria like anabina or nostra. They are found in the cyanobacteria like anabina are nasta. Okay, so these members of cyanobacteria, they show some special structures, some special cells in the filament, and those special cells are what is called heterocyst, and they are the nitrogen fixing centers in cyanobacteria. You know that cyanobacteria are also able to fix atmospheric nitrogen. Usually these members, they form symbiotic association with some of the forms. I will give the example later. Okay, so where the heterocyst, they consist of the enzyme, they encloses the enzyme nitrogenase. They encloses the enzyme nitrogenase. This is very much important for the fixation of atmospheric nitrogen. Nitrogenase. So where it will fixes atmospheric nitrogen. So for that reason, the heterocyst also surrounded by thick wall, which is impermeable to oxygen. It means it doesn't allow oxygen to enter inside. The reason because the enzyme nitrogenase, which is very much sensitive to oxygen. Once it comes in contact with oxygen, so its activity will be lost. It cannot able to fix the nitrogen further. Hence, the heterocyst will prevent the entry of oxygen. Their wall is impermeable to oxygen. Okay, because nitrogenase enzyme that fixes nitrogen without oxygen. Okay. So hence, the wall is impermeable to oxygen here. So what are heterocysts? Heterocysts are the special nitrogen fixing structures found in some of the filamentous forms of cyanobacteria, like in Anabina or in Nasta. And also these heterocysts, they are involved in reproduction. Okay, sometimes the filament may get detaches at the point of heterocyst. Yelli heterocyst irutha alli filament enagutte, sometimes that will detaches, the heterocyst that get detaches, and they can give rise to new filament. Okay, so I said fragmentation, no, where the filament that breaks into fragment. Okay, and each fragment is able to, that gives rise to a new filament, and here each fragment is what we call as harmogonia. Harmogonia, the fragment where that is able to give rise to new filament, and each fragment is what is called, known as harmogonia. Avagaledena filament is formed, the breaks into fragment, and each fragment that can give rise to new filament. So if it breaks into fragment, and those fragments were known as harmogonia. Agonites are the larger resting structures produced during the unfavorable conditions, surrounded by very thick wall and store large amount of nutrients or reserve food material. Whereas heterocysts are the nitrogen fixing structures which are found in few cyanobacteria like Anabina or Nasta. So where not only they fixes nitrogen, they also involved in reproduction. The filament may detaches at the point of attachment of heterocyst. Okay, so then the detached part that will grow into a new filament. Okay, so that is about the reproduction in cyanobacteria. Okay, so I said some cyanobacteria, they are not only the free living forms. Free living means they are either found in water or they may be found on the rock surfaces like colonial life. But some of the cyanobacteria, they are also symbiotic in nature. It means they show symbiotic association. I said what is symbiotic association, where both the partners are mutually benefited. They show symbiotic association with some higher organisms like a pteridophyte, a water fern called as Azolla. You might have heard about Azolla. This is a pteridophytic member. So where a cyanobacteria called as Anabina, I said with a heterocyst, Anabina, which will in a symbiotic association with Azolla. So where it can fix its atmospheric nitrogen. Okay. You just remember, those members with the heterocyst, they can only fix the atmospheric nitrogen. The other members, they can't fix the atmospheric nitrogen. Okay. So then similarly, in the coralloid roots of cycas, cycas is a gymnosperm. It is a gymnospermic plant. In the coralloid roots of cycas, we can see the symbiotic association of either Anabina or Nasta. Symbiotic association of Anabina or Nasta. So that can be observed in the coralloid roots of cycas. And also these cyanobacteria, they live in symbiotic association with fungi, where it lives in symbiotic association with fungi, and that is what is called as lichens. When algae or cyanobacteria, when it lives in symbiotic association with the fungi, and that association is what is known as lichens. You might have heard about lichens. Okay, so where lichen is a symbiotic association of algae or cyanobacteria along with fungi, that is what is called as a lichen. Okay, so This is about the symbiotic association of cyanobacteria. Okay, so I explained about the occurrence of cyanobacteria, the cell structure of cyanobacteria, then about reproduction. So then the symbiotic association in cyanobacteria. Okay, so this is about the blue-green and also the pigments, mainly phycocyanin and phycoerythrin, and the reserve food material is cyanophycian starch. Okay, so then the next concept is about the last members in the kingdom Monera, that is mycoplasma. The next form is mycoplasmas. See, mycoplasmas are the unicellular smallest. They are unicellular smallest anaerobic unicellular smallest anaerobic living cells. They are the smallest unicellular anaerobic living cells. It means they live without oxygen. Mycoplasmas, they live without oxygen, and they are unicellular in nature and they are anaerobic in nature. So I said they are nothing but they can live or survive without the oxygen. So they are the smallest prokaryotic cells. Mycoplasmas are the smallest prokaryotic cells, and they were first discovered by E. Nocard. This is asked in the examination twice or thrice for 1 marks. Who discovered mycoplasma? Mycoplasmas were discovered by E. Nocard and E. R. Rauchs. They were discovered by E. Nocard and E. R. Rauchs. They discovered mycoplasma for the first time. Okay. So, in a cattle, they were discovered mycoplasma in a cattle which is suffering from bovine pleuropneumonia. Bovine pleuropneumonia. It means this organism where it caused pneumonia in the cattle. Cattle is pneumonia caused by this organism, that is mycoplasma. So here pleuro, that refers to the membrane that surrounds the lungs, or membrane around the lung, that is what is called as pleuro. So where this organism that caused pneumonia in cattle, from the pleural fluid, means I said pleural means a membrane that surrounds the lungs, from the pleural fluid the mycoplasma was isolated first. Pleural fluid in the first mycoplasma isolate madara, then they discovered mycoplasma by E. Nocard and E. R. Rauchs, where it causes a disease in, that is what is called as pleuropneumonia. Pleuropneumonia na disease cause madittu cattle alli, allinda first mycoplasma isolate madidru. Okay, so thereafter, as it is isolated from the cattle by the disease what is called as pleuropneumonia, then it is also known as mycoplasma, also known as PPLO. PPLO means adadmelinda discover madid adadmelinda PPLO means pleuropneumonia like organisms. Pleuropneumonia like organism, that is PPLO. Pleuropneumonia like organism anta adana matte name martare. Okay, so as I said, they are the smallest living cells. They can live or survive in the anaerobic condition, in the anaerobic environmental condition. Okay, among this, the even smallest one is Mycoplasma galliseptacum. So this has asked twice or thrice in the examination for 1 marks. Name the smallest anaerobic living cell anta onsala kelidru, onsala athwa erdu sala kelidru. Okay, 1 marks ige. So the smallest living cell is Mycoplasma galliseptacum. You remember this one, this is important. Mycoplasma galliseptacum, this is the smallest living cell that can survive in anaerobic condition. So where that nearly measures about 0.1 to 0.25 microns in size. 0.1 to 0.25 microns in size. Okay, so this is the smallest one, Mycoplasma galliseptacum. Okay, and where the mycoplasmas can occur. See, the occurrence of mycoplasma, they mainly occurs in soil as saprophytes. So they mainly the saprophytic organisms. They mainly occurs in soil as saprophytes, saprophytic. Or they are also found in sewage water. They can be found in sewage water. Okay. and also they can be found as are seen as parasites. Means they cause diseases in plants as well as in animals and also in human beings. Okay. So they found as parasites, they may be saprophytes, they also found in sewage water. Okay. So this is about the occurrence of mycoplasma. So then what is about the structure of the cell? See here, the mycoplasmas where the cells do not have cell wall. The cells do not show cell wall. Illi cell wall irala, they lack cell wall. It means that the cells are only surrounded by the cell membrane or plasma membrane. There is no cell wall here. And they consist of a single double-stranded DNA in the center. And it encloses the protoplasm or the cytoplasm with some sort of reserve food material and the cell organelles like ribosome without any membrane bounded cell organelle, as it is a prokaryote. Okay. So where there is no cell wall, only cell membrane is present. Then a centrally situated double stranded DNA, then the protoplasm. As there is no cell wall in this forms, the cell shape that can change us to any form. They can occur in various forms. This is important here. As there is no cell wall in mycoplasmas, they can change us their shape. The cell shape, they can occur in various shape. Like spherical shape, cubical shape, or rod-like. Whatever it may be, they can occur in various shape. And that mechanism, that's why mycoplasmas are to be pleomorphic in nature. Pleomorphic means mycoplasmas can occur in various shape as there is no cell wall. Cell wall in there is various shape will be. That's why mycoplasma, this is also asked in examination, why mycoplasmas are regarded as pleomorphic. Because they lack the cell wall, they can occur in any shape, they can occur in various shape. That's why mycoplasmas are regarded as pleomorphic in nature. So, as they found in different forms, mycoplasmas are known as jokers of plant kingdom. As they found in different forms, mycoplasmas are also known as jokers of plant kingdom. Even now, jokers of plant kingdom antanu karitivi. Yake antandre, they found in different forms. They do not belong to plant kingdom. They are found in Monera, but earlier, okay, bacteria and other organisms, they were also included in the kingdom Plantae. So that's why they were known as jokers of plant kingdom. Okay. So as they found or occurs in various shapes or various forms, they are known as jokers of plant kingdom. Okay. So, this is about the cell nature of the mycoplasma. So, these mycoplasmas, as I said, they are maybe the parasites or they may be saprophytes. Okay, they may be found in sewage water. So, and also they cause us diseases in both the animals, in plants, as well as in human beings. Okay, so like pneumonia-like disease they cause. Okay, so and also in plants they cause us some diseases like, so this is also asked in the examination, give an example for the disease caused by mycoplasma. Okay. So like sandal spike disease in sandalwood, sandal spike disease in sandalwood. Okay, then witch's broom disease, then small leaf or little leaf of brinjal or chili, then bunchy top of papaya. Okay, so these are the diseases, some of the diseases caused by mycoplasma in plants. Plants are caused by the disease, like sandal spike disease, witch's broom disease, small or little leaf of chili or brinjal, then bunchy top of papaya. Okay. So, they are usually parasitic, they cause diseases in both plants as well as in animals. Okay. So, they may be saprophytes also. Okay. So, this is about mycoplasma. So, this is very important because one mark question is asked on mycoplasma twice or thrice or many times in the examination. Okay. You concentrate on this. So, in next video, I will start with the next kingdom, that is about the protista. Okay. Thank you.